The News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
Our fast-moving system is history now, and our clearing skies have moved in on schedule, and the stronger late February sunshine helping to melt the snow, especially on the roads. But there's going to be a hard refreeze later on tonight. There's a couple of flurries being picked up on the live Super Doppler 8 radar network in parts of eastern Ohio. So the News 8 Storm Team Forecast for the rest of this afternoon, mostly sunny. Definitely feels brisk and cold, though. Highs only 30 to around 34. Not too windy. We're benefiting from this storm system not redeveloping off the coast and stirring up the winds like we had over the weekend. Clear skies, very cold this evening, dropping down into the teens and going down into the single digits to near 10 probably overnight tonight, which could bring us near our record lows. The low for tomorrow is 6 degrees, set back in 1964, and that could be in a little bit of jeopardy. Now, taking a look at temperatures outside right now, officially we're at 24, a little bit of a brisk wind chill of 14. Winds are out of the west-northwest at only around 10 miles per hour, and the relative humidity a nice dry 43%. It's not just enough that we melt the snow that's on the roads. We've got to evaporate some of it before we get that refreeze later on tonight. So, especially on the main roadways, that will be possible. 25 in the White Rose City, 25 also in the Red Rose right now, 26 degrees in Chambersburg. And here's a look at the regional Doppler radars from about the peak of the storm, which was basically 10 p.m. to 1 a.m., just bands of sometimes moderate to heavy snowfall. And it wasn't just a heavy precipitation rate, very dry, very fluffy. So we were talking about probably a 15 to 20 to 1 ratio of inches of snow to inches of liquid. And that's why we got so much variability in some of the snowfall. The high-resolution visible satellite showing just a few of those thin clouds from this morning, those are the ones that are actually moving to the south, where you're seeing the gray areas staying put. That's where the fresh snowpack is. And here's a look at some of those reports we got. It looks like, again, the highest amounts were in the southwest, about 6.5 South Mountain, also Cashtown, Adams County, stretching down to the Hanover area. Everyone else was kind of in between. A lot of 5-inch numbers showing up there, and about 4.5 as you head towards Chester and Cecil County, Maryland. So, again, with clear skies tonight, dry air, the snowpack, calm winds, the heat of the day, what little we get goes right back into space. And we're talking about single digits to near 10 for low temperatures. But then sunshine again tomorrow gets us back up to near the freezing point, if not a little above, and then close to 40 degrees again on Thursday. So the pattern wants to shift right back. We get rid of this Arctic cold we have right now. And then the return flow around high pressure sends some more clouds our way on Thursday. So look for increasing clouds, and eventually some more moisture heads our way. And we'll start to get a taste of probably some rain as we head towards late Thursday night into the first part of Friday as well. So here's a look at the 7-day forecast. 34 for tomorrow, sunny and cold, increasing clouds on Thursday near 40 degrees, back into the mid-40s on Friday with it looks like a chance of a soaking rain. And then 42 degrees on Saturday, mostly sunny, and then a couple chances of rain on Sunday and probably next Tuesday as well. So, yeah, I know it's near 70 degrees on Friday, but it is still February. You can't have what happened last night. Luckily, the sunshine is helping out those roadways right now.
Yeah, as we said with Ed, it is pretty out there.
Yeah, if you don't have to drive on any ice, right. It's very pretty.
All right. Thanks, Matt.